Hello everyone, welcome to Home Cooking with me, Hima Subramanian. Today we are going to see two wonderful sandwiches. One is a vegetable mayo sandwich and the second one is a paneer sandwich. So why wait? Let's get started and check out these recipes. For the mixed vegetable sandwich, I've taken a lot of vegetables, different kinds of vegetables. Starting with a piece of green capsicum, finely chopped. A piece of red capsicum, finely chopped. Make sure whatever vegetables you're using, that you chop them nice and fine. A piece of yellow capsicum, finely chopped. Cucumber, finely chopped. One small carrot grated. A little cabbage, it's been finely chopped. A few spring onion greens chopped. If you don't have spring onions, you can use coriander leaves, finely chopped. To this, add 1/4 teaspoon salt, 1/4 teaspoon chili flakes. This is optional. If you don't like it spicy, you can just add pepper. Some freshly crushed pepper. Now add mayonnaise to the vegetables. Mix everything well. So if you need to add more mayonnaise, you can add another teaspoon or tablespoon, depending on the quantity of vegetables that you have. The filling should be a little creamy, not too dry. So I'm just going to add a little more mayonnaise. As you can see, mine is a little dry. This looks very good. I'm going to keep this aside. And I'm going to cut the bread slices. So I'm going to give you two options to make the sandwich. So one is going to be just a plain sandwich. Just cut off the edges. If you like the edges, you can keep them. But if I'm usually having a plain sandwich, I like to have it without the edges. Place the filling on one slice. Make sure you spread the filling across the bread slice. Oh, that looks good. Close the sandwich and gently just press it. Now gently just cut the sandwich, hold it in place. Cut it into desired shape, either triangles or rectangles, it's up to you. That looks amazing. So make sure you get fresh bread while doing this. Now I've used white bread, but you can use brown bread. You can use multi-grain bread. I'm going to make another sandwich. I'm going to grill this. So I'm not going to cut off the edges. So just spread it out evenly. Since I'm going to grill the sandwich, I'm going to place a slice of cheese. Now this is optional. If you don't want to, you don't have to. You can either grill the sandwich in a grill pan, or if you don't have a grill pan, you can just do it on a regular pan. You can just toast it. Take a little bit of the butter, grease the pan. Take a little bit of the butter, place it on top of the bread slice, just spread it out. Sandwich is done. Remove from the pan and you can serve it nice and hot. For the paneer sandwich, first I'm going to make the paneer filling. For this, take a kadai or a pan, add a little oil, about 1 tablespoon, 3 cloves of garlic chopped, 1 large onion chopped, 3 green chilies chopped, 2 this add 1 small capsicum finely chopped. You can add any color capsicum. Once the onions are a golden color, I'm going to season it first with 1 teaspoon of salt, 1 teaspoon of Kashmiri red chili powder, 1 teaspoon garam masala powder, 1 teaspoon amchur powder, 1 teaspoon chaat masala powder, 1 teaspoon coriander powder, 1 teaspoon cumin powder. Now mix everything well. Reduce the flame to a low while adding the spice powders. You don't want them to burn. I've taken 400 grams of paneer and I've cut into small cubes. If you don't like it as small cubes, you can also grate the paneer. Add the chopped paneer pieces to the masala, mix it well. Make sure the masala coats the paneer nicely. Let it cook for about 5 minutes on medium flame. The paneer is cooked. Finally, garnish it with some chopped coriander leaves. Turn off the stove. So next I'm going to grind the mint coriander chutney. I've taken a handful of coriander leaves, a handful of mint leaves, 2 green chilies, 2 cloves of garlic, a piece of ginger, 1 small onion chopped, the juice of half lemon. One teaspoon salt. Grind to a nice fine paste. The mint coriander chutney is ready. Take 2 slices of bread. Apply the bread slices with softened butter. Spread the mint chutney evenly on both the bread slices. Now place the filling on one slice. I've grated 2 cubes of processed cheese. You can adjust the cheese according to your preference. Close the sandwich with the other bread slice. So I'm going to grill the sandwiches on a grill pan. Add a little butter to the grill pan. Place the sandwich on the grill pan. Keep the flame on medium and grill the sandwich. Apply some butter on top of the sandwich. Flip the sandwich once it's turned golden brown color on one side. Once the sandwich has turned to a nice golden brown color on both sides, remove the sandwich from the pan. Serve the paneer sandwich while it's still hot. So there you go. Here are these 2 delicious sandwich recipes that you've seen. Now they're a meal by itself and they can be had anytime. And they're very quick and easy to make. So do try these recipes and post your comments and feedback in the comment section below.